السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Click on the picture. Sheen say, what can you hear? Please click. What is the sound? What can you hear? غين خ عين ح همز ها. Please listen to the next ayah and tell me, what are the colored letters that you heard in the surah? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. The مخرج of these letters, colored letters, is Hamza, Ain, Kha, and Ha. The مخرج of these letters is the throat. Let's learn about this مخرج and the letters that exit from it. If you want to learn about the throat letters, please watch this video with teacher Shaipa. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How are you, my students? My name is Shaima Bah. I am Quran and Arabic teacher. Inshallah, I will step by step with you to learn Quran, Arabic, and Tajweed rules. Today, inshallah, we will continue in studying the articulation points, مخارج الحروف. In the last class, we studied about the major areas for Arabic letters. There are five major areas. Start with al-jawf and end by al-shafatan, the lips. Al-khayshum, al-jawf, al-halq, al-shafatan, and al-lisan. Today, inshallah, we will study together al-halq, the throat. The throat, al-halq, has three areas, أدنى الحلق, وسط الحلق, and أقصى الحلق. The closest part of the throat, the middle part of the throat, and the deepest part of the throat. Today, inshallah, we will study together مخرج الحلق, the throat. The مخرج of the throat, it's the area between the uvula and the larynx. It contains six letters, three positions, the uvula and the larynx. The sound of six letters come from the throat. Hamzun, ha, aynun, ha, ghaynun, and kha. The deepest part of the throat is the area of the vocal cordis and the exit point of hamza and ha. Positions for the makhraj of the throat. Three positions. The closest part of the throat. Please repeat after me. Ah, ah. Put your finger. The sound comes from where? Yes, from the closest part. Adna al-halq. The middle part of the throat. Please repeat. Ah, ah. The sound comes from where? Yes, the middle part. The deepest part of the throat. Ah. Ah, the sound comes from where? Yes, the deepest part of the throat. Today, inshallah, we will study together two parts of the throat, the middle part and the deepest part. Our video today is two parts. First part, the deepest part of the throat, Hamzun and Ha. Second part is the middle part of the throat, Ainun and Ha. The sound of two letters, Ainun and Ha. A'h, ah. Let's start with the first part of the throat, is the deepest part, The first part today is the deepest part of the throat. Hamzun and ha. The sound of two letters. Hamzun and ha. Today, inshallah, we will study together 3 points about letter Hamza. Makhraj, characters, and examples for Hamza. Let's start with makhraj. The sound comes from where? Yes, the deepest part of the throat. A, U, E. السماء. Yes, from here. The sound of Hamza comes from here. Let's go to the second part of the throat, characteristics. صفات حرف الهمزة. Number one, ترقيق. It's a, not a. Number two, جهر. جهر. Can you hear the sound of press? No sound of press. جهر, not همز. شدة. The sound is running or no? No running. استفال. انفتاح. You raise your tongue or lower your tongue? Lower my tongue. Okay. Examples for Hamza. Please repeat after me. ما أن أتى أفعل بدأ أخذ أنهار. The second letter, the sound of the second letter come from the throat. It's letter Hamza. From where? The deepest part of the throat. أدنى الحلق. No, أقصى الحلق. أقصى الحلق. We will study together 3 points about ها. مخرج. Characters and examples. Let's start with makhraj. The sound of Hamza come from where? Yes, the deepest part of the throat. Number two, characters, صفات حرف الها. Hidden, it's hidden, not clear. Ha, it's hidden. Halqi, the sound come from al-halq. Number three, hams. Can you hear the sound of press? Yes, it's hams, not jah. Infitah. Ha. Rahawa. Yes, it's rahawa, not shidda. The sound is running. Tarkik. It's ha, not ha. Okay, this letter is weak or strong? Yes, it's weak. Examples for letter ha. Please repeat after me the examples. Hal, minha, hum, sayuhzamu, minhu, haula. Conclusion. 6 letter exit from the throat. Hamzon, ha, please. Tell me, what are the 6 letters? Hamzun, ha, ainun, ha, ghainun, and kha. Listen and notice, please listen and notice how ain and ha are pronounced. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ إِنَّ شَانِئَكَ هُوَ الْأَبْتَرُ. What are the colored letters that you heard in the surah? عَيْنٌ and ha. The makhraj of these letters is the middle of the throat. Letter ha. We will study together about letter ha. 3 points. Makhraj, characteristic, and title. Let's start with makhraj. Makhraj of letter ha come from where? The sound of ha come from where? Yes, it is the area between the uvula and the larynx. Characteristics for letter ha. صفات حرف الحاء. Number one, tarqiq. Letter ha always has tarqiq. Number two, hams. It's you can hear the sound of press when you pronounce the letter. Title for letter ha. Title means in Arabic al-laqab. Title is halqi. Harfun halqi. We studied together the middle part. What are the three positions? Closest part, middle part, and deepest part. Yes. Let's go to the second letter. Come from the deepest part of the throat. It's the letter I. Ah, ah. We will study together 3 points about letter I. Mahraj, characteristics, and title. It starts with mahraj. Mahraj of letter I or the articulation point for letter I. It is the area between the uvula and the larynx. Characteristic, al-jah. Ah, can you hear the sound of press? No sound of press. Number two, tarqiq. Ah, not ah. The sound is light, not heavy. Tawassut. Tawassut means the sound isn't running. The sound is run or no? No. A letter has neither shidda or rakhawa. Okay? It's a tawassut. Tawassut letters compounded in the sentence Lin Omar. What is the title or al-laqab for letter ayn? Halqi, harfun halqi. Conclusion. Letter ayn and ha exit from the middle of the throat between the uvula and the larynx. Both letters ayn and ha have tarqiq. Letter ha shouldn't be mixed with ayn or ha, like saying hadara instead of hadara or akhla instead of a'la, which is a common mistake for non-Arabic speakers. Letter ayn and ha exit from the middle of the throat between the uvula and the larynx. Both letters ayn and ha have tarqiq. Letter ha shouldn't be mixed with ayn or ha, like saying hadara instead of hadara. No, yes, no. Correct pronunciation. النطق الصحيح. Number one, izhar should be applied to letter ayn when repeated, especially if they have different haraka. Example, yanzi'u anhuma. The right pronouncing is yanzi'u anhuma. The wrong is yanzi'anhuma. Izhar should be applied to letter ayn when repeated, especially if they have different haraka. Example, la abrahu hatta. The right pronouncing is la abrahu hatta. The wrong is la abrah hatta. Tarqiq should be applied for letter ha because it has fatha and it's followed by alif mad. Hafizu. It's hafizu, not hafizu. Fatha of letter ayn should be pronounced clearly. Example, ma'ahu. The right pronouncing is ma'ahu. The wrong is ma'ah. Ma'ah. The sound of letter ayn when it's sakin, whether original, sukoon, or for waqf, should be partially imprisoned or partially running. Example, a'hadu. Not, it's a'hadu. The sound, please clear the sound. A'hadu, not ahadu. No. Tarqiq should be applied to letter ha when it's followed by a letter that has tafkhim. Example, has, hasa. It's has, hasa, not ha, has, hasa. No ha, it's ha. Letter عين shouldn't be mixed with ha or ha. Example, الأعلى. It's الأعلى, not الأهلى. No, or الأحلى. No. Now I want to test your knowledge about letter عين and ha. عين and ha. Are you ready? Are you ready? Okay, I will ask you four questions. Number one, the first question, extract from Quran words with throat letters. The second question, true or false? The third question, choose the correct answer. The fourth question, listen and choose the correct pronunciation. Let's start with the first question. Extract from Quran words with throat letters. Please highlight the words which has a letter that exits from the deepest or the middle part of the throat. Look at the surah. Read the surah. Huh, which word can you find? Yes, Alhamdu, letter Ha. Al-Alameen, letter Ayn. Iyaka, letter Hamza. إهدنا letter ها أنعمت two letters همزة and عين yes and عليهم letter عين please highlight the words which has a letter that exists from the deepest or the middle part of the throat yes وعددة please look ها huh? إصلاح بإحسان yes ها huh? على الموسع yes السماء هل أتاك yes number two true or false the closest part of the throat is the مخرج of the letters همزة and ح right or wrong no wrong the deepest part of the throat is the مخرج of letters همزة and ح right the مخرج of letter عين is the middle of the throat right قل هو الله أحد. This ayah contains letters that exit from the three positions of the throat. The middle, the deepest part, and the closest part. Look at the ayah. Hamzun ha. Where is Hamzun ha? Yes. Ahadun huwa. From where? The deepest part. Ha. Aynun ha. Ha only, not ayn. The middle part. Can you find ghainun ha? No, I can't. So this is wrong. Not right. Wrong. Number three, please choose the correct answer. The makhraj of letter عين is what? Huh? Which one? Yes, the middle part of the throat. The makhraj of letter ha is which one? The middle part of the throat. The makhraj of the middle of the throat is the area between what? Between what? Yes, the uvula and the larynx. Letter عين and the ha, huh? Both have tarqiq. Which word has halqi letters? Which one? Which one? Ahsana. Yes. Let's go to the last part of questions. Listen and choose the correct pronunciation. Please listen. Al-a'la, al-ahla. Which one is right? Yes, the first one. Al-a'la. Has, has, hasa. Hoss, hossa. Which one? The first or the second? The second it's ha, has, hossa. The first is hoss, hossa. No ha, it's ha. Fa'asa, fa'asa. It's fa'a or fa'a? No, the first, fa'a, fa'asa. Yanzi'anhuma, yanzi'u anhuma. Which one is right? Yanzi'u anhuma or yanzi' anhuma? Yanzi'u anhuma, the first one. Yanzi'u anhuma. Hadara, hadara. Which one is right? Hadara, hadara. The second one, hadara. The first one, hadara. Alhamdulillah, you finished the test. Excellent. Very good. Congratulations. MashaAllah. I am proud of you. Okay, please tell me what we studied together today. What we studied? Today we studied the second articulation point, the throat. مخرج الحلق. Alhamdulillah, we finished studying the throat. No, today we didn't. We did only two parts from the throat, the deepest part and the middle part of the throat. We did وسط الحلق, the middle part, and أقصى الحلق, the deepest part. Inshallah, in the next lesson, we will study together the closest part of the throat, أدنى الحلق. Okay, now it's time to leave you. That's great to see you today. Please, if this video is useful for you, don't forget to make like, share, and subscribe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.